When saving your SOLIDWORKS data into the 3DEXPERIENCE platform, care must be taken to understand the different options you have available to you for unique identification of your data, in other words, part number. In the 3DEXPERIENCE platform, for part number, we have Enterprise Item Number, or EIN for short. EIN is the recommended method for part numbering in the 3DEXPERIENCE platform. EIN presents a configurable way for you to set up part numbering. It can be manual entry, a simple prefix or counter, or something a bit more complex and formula-based, for example, project-based part numbering. Once set up by a platform administrator, EIN can be set by SOLIDWORKS users inside the SOLIDWORKS interface, either on individual parts or on several parts at once. Here we have a part open in SOLIDWORKS that's already been saved to the platform that we wish to set the EIN for. We'll first go into its properties and set the project number. Once that's set, we can save the changes back to the platform and set the EIN. Directly from within SOLIDWORKS, we can select our part, set the EIN. If there are existing numbers already set, we can choose to clear them, and we can simply request a new EIN from the 3DEXPERIENCE platform. So the EIN has been set, and if we go back into the properties, we'll now see it listed there. So we've got our project number and then the next available counter. We can also configure our feature tree inside of SOLIDWORKS to show the EIN and perhaps the revision of the part to make it very clear what we've got as our part number inside of the platform. Once EIN is set, it's then available as a custom property that we can add to our templates. And it can then be easily referenced in a SOLIDWORKS drawing border or inside a SOLIDWORKS bill of materials or perhaps a balloon in an assembly exploded view. EIN can also be set by non-CAD users if they have a BOM capable role such as product release engineer to ensure that parts and assemblies have the correct part numbering applied. Here we have an assembly with its structure open in the engineering release application, part of the product release engineer role. We can see the existing enterprise numbers that have been applied. So we can either, again, individually apply new enterprise item numbers, EIN, or select all and choose to do it in bulk. So we select all of the items, choose to set our enterprise item number, and we can simply request new enterprise item numbers for the selected items and choose to set. So again, new enterprise item numbers generated for the entire structure here. So before this goes out to suppliers or to manufacturing, all of the correct part numbering has been applied. EIN provides a simple, convenient method to assign part numbers in the 3DEXPERIENCE platform. If you'd like to know more, please get in touch with us. Thank you.